forgot, Mr. Tinsworthy is on his way up, so you know there's that.
Tinsworthy's here? Now?
Who's Tinsworthy?
He's the chairman of the board.
Shit.
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 Shit. Shit.
Mom, shoot! Je suis ici!
Oh, shit!
What's with the PJs?
Mr. Tinsworthy, it's the end of the week, and we feel that we're more productive if we're more relaxed. So Mr. Hart came up with something called Casual Friday.
Casual Friday. I like it. But today's Thursday.
Oh, you know Mr. Hart always ahead of the curve.
I'll say. Hart, I am dumbfounded by what's been happening in this division over the last 4 weeks.
And I'm so glad you're here so we can clean up this mess. You need to know what's been going on.
Damn right. I need to know who's responsible.
These women.
For the 20% rise in productivity.
Wait, what?
You said it was these women?
Yes. No, I mean Violet was the ringleader with
that. Violet? Oh, I cannot believe it, it's you. I've known all about you for the last few years.
Well, thank you, Mr. Tinsworthy.
So, Ms. New said, how's it going?
Oh, sir, I think we're talking
Hart,
about two different
things. Please, I am talking to a lady.
Well, sir, Mr. Tinsworthy, my two colleagues, Dorley Rhodes and Judy Burnley, and I thought it was time to make some changes to the office.
We thought with a few changes like job sharing, flexible hours, and daycare, we could really improve the quality of life here at Consolidated.
And increase productivity at the same time.
Oh, and Mr. Hart signed off on all the changes. Dorley has copies of all the memos.
How many memos are we talking about here?
About 100.
Hart, I am pleased that you are encouraging such positive creativity. And from secretaries, no less.
Oh, Lord, here we go.
I think it's time you got a promotion, Hart. I want you by my side.
Oh, it would be an honor, sir.
Sir, I think you just might want to take a look at this file
before
first.
We get to that, sir, I think you know what these three have really been up to. In spite of all the sacrifices I've made to make this company feel like a family.
Oh, a family!
Oh, in spite of all I've done. To make sure my girls reach their greatest potential.
Your girls?
While these three girls were painting the desks and hanging curtains in the Xerox room, sir, they were also holding me
hostage.
Violet!
Excuse me?
Oh, it's no use. He's gonna get away with it anyways. We might as well come clean. But before we spend the next 30 years in prison making pen pals in Nebraska, I have a few things I want to say. This place was hell before we fixed it. We are the ones that do all the work of running this place as best as we can, Mr. Tinsworthy. Not him. He plays golfs and drinks whiskey and takes the credit. And you know why? Because he's the guy.
Now, wait a minute.
No, you wait a minute. I have waited my whole life. You see, we're not the guy. We are the little guy. The little guy doesn't play golf. He plays catch-up. The little guy's late getting to work because of the kids and late getting to picking up the kids because of work. The little guy coaches ball and squeezes a dollar as far as it can go and works her ass off. And if that doesn't make her deserve to be seen and heard, then what does? So, yes. We kidnapped Mr. Hart and threw him in the back of my Buick.
We tied him up like a little pig at the state fair.
Strung him up with the garage door opener.
And now we're gonna get 10 to life and he's gonna get all the credit.
Oh,
Little lady, you are one hell of a joker.
No, sir, they really...
But I am impressed by everything I've seen here. It's time you rose all the way to the top.
Oh, I thank you, sir.
The Bolivian operation is just beginning to take off. I could use a man like you.
Bolivia?
Mm-hmm.
Well, congratulations, Mr. Hart. It happens to the more deserving person.
Oh, what about Violet? She knows as much about the office as I do.
Another brilliant idea. Only a visionary like you would suggest a female CEO.
No, wait, I did.
That is, if you want the job, Violet.
Oh, yes, I want it.
Appreciate the opportunity.
Better get packing, friend. I've heard inside info that there may be a military coup down there, and you better come back and pay travel.
Oh, so if we could just discuss this.
I don't take no for an answer. Bob.
Bob?
It's funny, right?
Congratulations.
Yeah. But seriously, we hope you enjoyed it, and we hope you tattle.